So maybe you've been thinking about moving to the Myrtle Beach area and looking for the perfect home to entertain. Maybe you're looking for an open concept floor plan, possibly with a built-in grill and fire pit in the patio. There is a brand new listing in the farm at Timberlake that has 3 bedrooms, 2 baths that just hit the market that might check off all your boxes. Hey everybody and welcome. My name is Olivia Laskowski. I'm a local realtor here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina with RE/MAX Southern Shores. On my channel here, I talk about all things real estate. We explore different communities together and even check out some new listings. So if you're interested and that is something that you'd like to benefit from, please do subscribe. There's a link below that you can do so. I've helped many folks just like yourself that are looking to move to the Grand Strand area. And I get calls and emails all the time from people reaching out about questions, looking to move to the area. So if that is you, don't hesitate to reach out, whether it's sometime this year or many years down the road. I'd love to be a great resource along the way. Today we're going to go down towards the south end of Myrtle Beach. We're going to go explore the farm at Timberlake, which is a DR Horton community. They began building back in 2016, and in their first phase they built about approximately 283 homes, and they stopped in 2020. A couple years later, in 2022, they began their second and final phase, which is about 170, give or take, more homes, and they just finished building this year in 2024. The farm at Timberlake is a natural gas community, and children in the neighborhood will attend St. James schools in the area. They have a monthly HOA fee of $95 per month. That does include your weekly trash pickup and all the amenities. They have their main pool and clubhouse near the beginning of the neighborhood, where you'll also find an indoor pickleball court and a fitness room. Across the street on the big pond, they have a fishing pier where they stock the pond for catch and release fishing, as well as a playground. In their second phase, they did add another pool in the back of the community. The home we're about to see is a Cumberland model by DR Horton. It was built in 2018 and is just shy of 2,200 heated square feet. There's an attached 2-car garage and it has 3 bedrooms and 2.5 bathrooms. The home sits on the big pond in the neighborhood and is on 0.19 acres and it just came on the market for $509,900. Here we've got the exterior view of the home, a great new listing by Layne, Mureddu here in RE/MAX Southern Shores in the Garden City office. Great landscaping and curb appeal. Got low maintenance over here with the rocks and these beautiful patio pavers as it brings you into the front double doors of the home. Upon walking into the house, you can't see it because of the glare, you get a beautiful view of the pond. Immediately off to the right side, we do have a powder room, which is perfect for having guests over, so they have a little space. And on the front left side of the home, there is going to be the 2 guest bedrooms. Pretty good size for both of them. Lots of space, very neutral, and they did choose to do the vaulted ceiling in this one. And the closets are very ample size as well for being guest rooms. Moving on, these 2 rooms do share the same bathroom, but it does have the double vanity. It's got the quartz countertops and it has a tub shower combo. And they did include that extra window above the shower to help bring in a lot of extra natural light. Plus, there's a bonus linen closet behind the door, which is great for some added storage. And not that you'll need it here in South Carolina, but there is a little coat closet off to the side, which you can always, you know, tuck away your vacuums and brooms. Here we've got the second guest bedroom. This one is pretty good size as well. It just feels a little bit more cramped since there are 2 full-size beds in here. Great space size. And both of these 2 bedrooms do have the carpet, but you're going to find an engineered hardwood and LVP flooring throughout the rest of the house. There is some really nice molding going on. You've got the thicker baseboards, and then there is some crown molding across the top as well.
Here we've got a great view of the open concept floor plan. So the living room flows to the dining room and the kitchen. On the back side here, we do have a nice backsplash that really complements the color of the house. We've got the natural gas stove. And then a really large kitchen island with the sink. And it's got really cute pendant lights over the top. This could be used as kind of a morning sitting room where you sip your coffee. You can do like a little eat-in breakfast. Sits over here to the side right by the pantry. And headed to the back, we do have the spacious laundry room. So it does fit the full-size washer and dryer. Plus they added in some additional storage. And there is a nice drop zone as you enter in through the garage. So perfect to hang your purses or your coats or just tuck away your shoes. This is the access to the two-car garage. They did epoxy the floor in here, so that's a nice little bonus. There's also the pull-down attic space where you can access your air handler. And there's some plywood up there too, so if you want to store your Christmas decorations or whatnot, there's some space up there as well. Heading back into the main living area, there are plantation shutters throughout the main living room and over in the dining room. And this is a very great size space. This table easily seats six, but you can probably put another larger one too if you wanted to seat up to eight. And there's the really tall ceilings throughout. This is a neat little feature. It's kind of like a built-in bar area. There is a wine fridge on the left side. And then it's got the glass face cabinet. So if you wanted to include any fancy china or some glassware, you can always feature it there. They did include the gas fireplace as well, which makes a really nice focal point for the living room. On the back side of the home, we do have the primary bedroom, and it does feature a tray ceiling. It does have the really nice pond view on the back as well. Moving into the ensuite bathroom, there is the toilet that is in its own separate closet, which is always one of my favorites. It does have a dual vanity as well and plenty of cabinet space. Got a soaker tub if you choose to take a bath, or you've got a nicely tiled stand-up shower as well. Moving along into the closet, it does have really great organization with the different shelving systems they've got going. So like I said, nice space throughout so it doesn't feel like you're really on top of everything. And then, of course, what everybody dreams of, the perfect patio. We've got a really large slider here that opens up both ways. And there are screen doors that you can pull shut as well. But you wouldn't really need it since the patio is going to be screened in. Plus, it's got the nice ceiling fan for those extra hot summer days. So you could easily dine in there. And then if you wanted to make your way out for a little sitting area, here we've got a built-in grill and beautiful views of the pond. And there's also a fire pit right there as well. So you can put a few Adirondacks out there and have a nice winter evening. And the view from that fishing pier from the community is right there across the lake. So you're not far from the main amenity center at all. And that's just a really nice feel. Even if it's rainy, you can still sit on the screened-in patio and enjoy the breezes. And there is also a retractable awning as well, which is a bonus feature if you need a little bit more shade on the back patio.
I really hope you enjoyed that home as much as I did. I really enjoyed the open concept floor plan and all the space that they had, as well as the outdoor patio, which is just something you don't always see in many of these homes. There's plenty of space for everybody to gather and really entertain, but not everyone's gonna be on top of each other. you have any other questions about this particular home or real estate in the Myrtle Beach area, I'd be happy to connect with you. There's a link down in my bio that you can click to set up a call with me. And while you're down there, if you like this video, I would really appreciate a thumbs up. That would mean the world to me. I look forward to talking to you either sometime this year or maybe even next year when you plan to relocate to the Grand Strand area. Just want to say thanks so much for tuning in, and I look forward to seeing you again next week in our next video. See ya!